In more local news now, the Cherry Blossom Festival wrapped up in March. Mother Nature threw a wrench into some of the festivities, but that did not hurt the event's economic impact on Macon and Bibb County. 41 NBC's Fiona King has more.
We had a few days of rain, which impacted us, but you can't rain on our parade, literally and figuratively. We were super excited to have people from all over the state, region, and nation join us, and we just want to continue to work to bring everyone out together in March.
Even though the rain caused the Cherry Blossom Festival to postpone some events, it still had a record economic impact.
Community-wide, we saw an economic impact of more than $6 million this year, which is up from last year of $5.5 million.
According to Aaron Buzza, Vice President and COO of Visit Macon, there were over 186,000 local visitors, a 16% increase from last year. And he says more than 38,000 visited from outside of Macon, a 6% increase from the previous year.
We see a lot of visitors from the Southeast, a good number from Florida, quite a few from South Carolina, Tennessee, and Alabama especially. And so those visitors, because it's a relatively easy drive for them to get here, makes it very approachable.
Buzza says the record-breaking visitation was huge for the city of Macon.
With that many visitors coming to town, you know, certainly they're coming for the festival. They're coming for the trees. They're coming for all aspects of what the festival has to offer over the course of the 10 days. But they're going to visit shops. They're going to visit restaurants. They're going to stay in hotels. And so community-wide, we see a great benefit from the festival because what you're doing with the festival is a portion of your day, but there's also opportunity to do other things.
The director of marketing and fulfillment at the Cherry Blossom Festival, Hannah Theus, shared a heartwarming experience that one out-of-town visitor had at the festival.
Some of our new things this year, we had a tethered hot air balloon at Carolyn Creighton Park that was very well received. We actually had a couple come from Boston to get engaged on it, and so that was really exciting. We had a great reach nationally with that.
According to Visit Macon, 51% of visitors who traveled 50 or more miles stayed in Macon for more than 2 days. Buzza says they used a company called Datafi to track the festival's success.